Hello, today we're going to look at read underscore to underscore string, read to string with Rust, and we're going to read the entire contents of a file into a string. This is the Rust documentation. As you can see, there are numerous different outcomes. There's okay, there's also error. What I'll just quickly show you without frightening the hell out of all of us, this is the actual code. So we've got within the core Rust code, we've actually got okay. And we've got error here, so there and there. These are two potential outcomes that we will be using within our code. So without further ado, we're going to say let contents equals, and then we're going to use match, and we're going to actually select the outcome based upon whether we get a successful read of our text file. So okay, which you just saw, and the other option was error. So depending on whether we get back the message or we get an error, then we will say missing file, wrong name. That will do for starters, just to get us going. And then if we get back a successful message, then we will have some good contents, and then we will print the contents on line 12. So let's just run that. And here we go. Hello, this is the text for the video. And if we go across to the text file, there we see that was what I put in. There we go. So if I run it again, there we see it's changed, it's updated. I updated the text file, and it's obviously definitely reading it from that text file. So this is a very quick video showing you how to use read underscore to string. As I say, it's not the most performant, but it works, and there are numerous other options available to you, which you can find within the Rust documentation, which is excellent. As I said, the performance, the downside of this function is increased ease of use and type safety, is that it gives you less control over performance. For example, you can't pre-allocate memory like you can using string with capacity and read to string. Also, you can't reuse the buffer if an error occurs with while reading. In many cases, the function's performance will be adequate, and the ease of use and type safety trade-offs will be worth it. However, there are cases where you need more control over performance, and in those cases, you should definitely use read to string from read. And as I say, you've got the OK, you've outcome, which is there. You've got error, as we saw. And in VS Code, if you ever see long error messages, you can always hold down control and then actually go and visit the code, which gives you some sort of insight into what's going on underneath the bonnet. If you're new, just learning, contains the success value, contains the error value. You can see which version of Rust it came in with. Obviously, there's three main versions. So that is how to read text file. If I just change that so that it doesn't, the file I'm looking for doesn't exist, and then we run it. There we go, missing file, wrong name. So the within the match statement, or the case, if you're more familiar with the case from other languages, or switch statement in Python, that is false, and this line is true. So this line runs because this file name is not matching this file name. Hope that's been interesting. Any questions, comments, let me know. I'm still learning, so any input will be very welcome. Thank you for watching, and I'll be back soon.